So keep going.
我们继续上课。
We were talking about reading Quran, understanding Quran, reciting Quran, memorizing Quran. Now all of those things, they are the things that they will eat Quran totally in our heart and in our brain and in our deeds and actions. Why do we need Quran in our life? Why do we need to follow Quran in our life? Because actually Quran should be the measurement of our actions and behavior. When I feel that I have a problem in my throat, I go to the doctor and ask him. When my car has a problem in the voice of the engine, then I have to go to the engineer to check it. Now what when I have a problem in my belief? What do I have to do? I have to find the doctor. So the doctor is Quran. I have to check where am I from Quran. I like to have fun. I like to spend time playing on maybe video games or whatever. Then I have to think, where am I from Quran? Then I start to check. Then I find that Allah says in Quran in chapter 23, believers are those who are away, are those who are praying with submission. And who are away from wasting time and saying nonsense things. So I will find myself away from Quran. Away from following Quran. Because I'm wasting time and saying nonsense things. So whenever I want, so if I really want to have a peaceful life, then I put myself in front of Quran and I check how far or close am I to this Quran. Like Allah says in Quran that believers, they should be moderate and nice to people. And when ignorant people are talking to them, they ignore them. Then I examine myself, I check. Am I from those people that Allah says in Quran that they are moderate and when ignorant people talk to them, they ignore them? Am I from them?
我是不是像阿拉所讲的那一种真正信仰阿拉的人一样，就是我对人非常的谦和，就是温和，然后遇到一些无知的人在。
Or I am an arrogant and I am an argument person.
还是我是一个很自大骄傲的人，那么遇到人的话，就很喜欢跟他辩论，很喜欢跟他争辩。
Actually, we have five pillars of Islam.
我们伊斯兰有五功。
And we have five pillars of belief.
我们有五大信念、信仰。
Now, what are the five pillars of belief?
伊斯兰的五大信念。
Belief. The five pillars of belief. First is to believe that is to believe in Allah.
伊斯兰的五大信念，五大信仰，第一个呢就是要信仰阿拉。
Now, when I believe in Allah, what does it mean?
我信仰阿拉的意思是什么？
It means that I have to believe that Allah is the only one.
就是我要相信阿拉是唯一的真神。
And He is able to do everything.
他有办法做任何事情。
And He is the creator.
他是宇宙万物的造物主。
And He is the judge on judgment day.
他是审判日的审判者。
And the thing that we mentioned last time about Allah, who is Allah?
就是我上次有讲到阿拉的一些特质。
So it is not only that I say, okay, I believe in Allah.
不是说我嘴巴说啊，我相信阿拉。
Are you deeds telling us that you believe in Allah?
你的行为举止是不是有在证明说你这个信仰阿拉？
So it is to believe in Allah, to believe in His angels.
所以我们要信仰阿拉，然后信仰阿拉的天使。
To believe in His messengers.
那信仰他的使者。
To believe in His holy books.
信仰他的经典。
And to believe that there is judgment day.
要去相信有审判日。
Now those are the five pillars of belief.
这是五大信念。
How about the five pillars of Islam?
那么伊斯兰的五功是什么？
The five pillars of Islam is to witness that no God but Allah and Muhammad is His messenger.
伊斯兰五功的第一个呢，就是作证，就是阿拉是唯一的真神，那么千真万确的是他的使者。
And to pray.
然后第二个就是要礼拜。
And to fast.
然后第三个就是要去斋戒。
And to donate to pay zakat.
然后第四个就是要去捐钱，就是付这个天课。
And the fifth one.
那么第五点。
Telegram.
就是朝觐。
Now what are they?
那么这五样东西在哪里？
Those are the five pillars of Islam, right?
这是伊斯兰的五功五大基础。
Where is Islam then?
那么伊斯兰在哪里？
Those are the pillars.
这五个是五个大的柱子。
Then I have to build Islam on those pillars.
我要建造这个伊斯兰的殿堂，我必须要去根据这五大的五根柱子去建造。
So actually, this is not the only thing that I have to do in my life.
所以说，作为一个穆斯林，不是说我人生当中只要做这五件伊斯兰的五功就好了。
This is only the beginning.
因为这只是一个基础，这只是一个开始而已。
Then we start to build on it.
我们必须要根据这五大基础，然后呢，去盖我们这个。
We start to build the Islam on those pillars.
我们要把伊斯兰建立在这五大基础之上。
Now to build Islam on those pillars, I have to follow Quran.
要根据这伊斯兰五功这五根梁柱来建造伊斯兰的殿堂，我必须要去遵守《古兰经》。
I have to be moderate.
我必须要对人温和。
And I have to be nice to people.
我必须要对人和善。
And I should be away from evil things.
我必须要去远离一些邪恶的东西。
Backbiting,
不要去背后重伤人家或是吝啬。
Those are the evil things that I have to be away from.
这些都是我要去远离的一些不好的东西。
Then I have to be honest.
然后我还要诚实待人。
And I shouldn't tell lies.And I shouldn't think too much of myself.
我不要常常都只是想到自己而已。
And actually, this is important.
事实上，这是很重要的。
If I really put Allah my first priority in everything I do,
如果我所做的每件事情都把阿拉放在第一个要件
，Then as much as Allah is important to me, I will be important to Allah.
只要在我的心里，阿拉是最重要的。那么对阿拉而言，我也是最重要的。
If you want to know who are you to Allah,
如果你想知道对阿拉来讲，你到底算什么
？You check who is Allah to you.
那你先扪心自问说，阿拉在你的心里是排第几位
？And there is another way also to know who are you to Allah.
另外一种方式要去
you check what are the responsibilities Allah gave you.
你要想一下，你去查看看，就是阿拉赋予你的职责任务是什么？
Are you working in a nightclub?
你是在一家夜店工作吗？
Then you can know where is your level.
那你
in Allah,
你就可以知道说，对阿拉来讲，你的层次在哪里？
Or are you working as a guardian of one masjid?
那还是你是在一家清真寺里面做守卫？
Are you working the general manager of a company selling alcohol?
你是在一家卖酒的公司当总经理。
Or you are working as a cleaner in a masjid?
还是你是在一家清真寺，在一个清一座清真寺里面负责打扫。
Which one is better?
哪一个是比较好？
The second one, suppose that it is the second one.
照理说应该是第二个是比较好。
Of course, the first one is better when we are talking about this one.
当然，如果你要讲到这一辈子来讲的话。那当然，第一个可能这个职位是比较好的。
But just to give you an idea of judgment day.
但是给大家一点对审判日的概念。
Angels will bring this is hadith. You know, I'm not saying something from me.
现在我
要 or hadith.
我讲的现在讲的就是圣训里面所讲的，我讲的都是古兰经跟圣训所讲的。
Angels on judgment day, they bring the one who was extraordinarily rich, powerful, and big.
在审判日的时候，天使呢会带来一个在这一辈子位高权重、富甲十方的一个很有地位的人来。
But he was a disbeliever. He didn't believe.
这个人他并不信仰阿拉。
So he was hurting people, doing bad things to people, never believing in Allah.
他伤害了，虽然他很有钱，但是他伤害了很多人。然后呢，他做了许多阿拉所不允许的事情，也不信仰阿拉。
So the one like this, suppose that he will go to hell.
照理说，这样的人应该是会下地狱。
So angels will put him 1 second in the air, 1 second of this life, the calculation of this life.
天使会把它放在地狱一秒钟。
Why I say the calculation of this life, maybe some they didn't hear this before.
就是为什么说是这辈子的一秒钟？
Because Allah says in Quran.
因为阿拉在古兰经里面说。
One day there.On judgment day,
在审判日，在天堂地狱的一天
，equal to 50,000 years of this life，
等于这辈子的50,000年的时间。
So now it is clear.
这样很清楚。
Angels, they will put that disbeliever in the hell 1 second of this life.
天使会把那一个这辈子位高权重却做了很多坏事的人放到地狱一秒钟，就这辈子的一秒钟。
Only to show them his place in the hell.
只是让他知道说他以后要去的，他要去的地狱在哪里。
And take him out.
然后再把他带出来。
Then they will ask him.
然后呢，他们就会问这个人。
Tell us about your enjoyment in your life.
你来说说你这辈子到底享受过什么好的东西。
He will say, I swear by Allah, I never had even 1 second of enjoyment in all of my life.
他会说凭着阿拉启示，我这一辈子。
He forgot it ten total.
因为在去地狱这一秒钟之后，他把这辈子所有的享受全部都忘光了。
In another hand,
那另外一方面
，someone who was very poor,
一个很穷的人
，suffering a lot,
他受了很多苦难
，and even sick,
也生病
，and low profile in this life, people they
disrespect. 这辈子没有地位啊，受到人家的轻视。
But he was a good believer.
但是他是一个好的信使。
And he was following his mom the right way, worshiping Allah the right way.
他正确的方式去遵守伊斯兰。
Angels, they put him in paradise, only 1 second to show him his place and take him out.
天使呢，把他放到天堂里面，就只有一秒钟，让他去看一下他在天堂的位置在哪里。
Then,
再把他带出来。
They ask him.
然后呢，他们就问这个人。
Tell us about your suffering in your life.
来说说你这辈子到底是吃过什么苦。